The Thermal Uniformity Report requires a data connector to a PLC. In this case, I'm connecting to my local PLC through RS links. Notice that there's the provision to define a secondary server, which is used if the primary server cannot be communicated to. This is an automatic transition by XLReporter. With the connector defined, I can go and create a template. Here I have the Thermal Uniformity Report drawn out using Excel formula, conditional formatting, and a place for the technician to sign. All the formula here are referencing the raw data that's going to appear in the readings area. The readings area is in four pieces. There's a piece for the first set point, there's another area for the second set point, and the actual readings will be presented here. The readings are put into this report through connections to the RS links. What I have here are 10 thermocouple readings, and they are going to be placed at B14, and they're going to be appended down if the current row is occupied with data. Likewise, this is also the 10 thermocouple readings with the timestamp on the first column, and those values are going to be put in AL14, again going down. Notice that each of these connections are in groups. Groups 1, 2, 3, and 4. And that is used by the scheduler to determine which group to use. For instance, here, if the PLC bit called read set point 2 goes high, then we will update group 2 every 2 minutes. Likewise, if read set point 4 goes high, we will update group 4 every 2 minutes. So the population of the report is controlled by the PLC, putting this bit high and holding it there for the duration of the report. The report itself is going to be governed by the following naming convention. And in this case, we have a naming convention for the folder and also one for the report itself. So, let's take a look at what it looks like finished. I'm going to use XLReporter's workbook viewer. This can be launched from an HMI or from a desktop. It doesn't use Excel, but it can still be able to display Excel files. On the readings tab, I have readings now for each set point. And then on the report tab, I have an indication of whether the thermocouple temperatures were within tolerance. At this stage, the technician would print this off, get a signature, the thing would get put in a filing cabinet, and the laptop would get disconnected and moved to the next account.